Hello everyone, I'm Ahmed Gad from PTech. In this first session, we will explain how can we calculate the milli equivalence and how can we solve the problems related to milli equivalence in milli equivalence calculations. Firstly, what is the milli equivalence and what is the formula that we will use? Then we will see some applications for these topics. Milli equivalence is a unit of measure often used for electrolytes. We use it to describe the electrolytes and the concentration present in these electrolytes. It is a chemical unit used to express the concentration for the electrolytes in a solution. And in other words, it is a unit of measurement of amount of chemical activity of an electrolyte. And this unit will measure related to the total number of ionic charges in solution. So we will depends on the valency and it takes note of the valence of the ions. Let us see the formula. The formula saying that the milli equivalence is equal the weight in milligram. We should use the weight in milligram. The unit of the weight should be by milligrams because here we have the milli equivalence over the molecular weight of the electrolyte. This molecular weight should be divided by the valency. So we have here mEq is the milli equivalence equal the weight in milligram. It should be in milligram over the molecular weight, whatever the unit of it. And this molecular weight should be divided over the valency. How can we know the valency of any compound? This table, we will find most important valences, most important ions that we will use in most of calculation problems, like lithium, sodium, potassium, calcium, zinc, magnesium, aluminium. Here you will find the atomic weight, while here is the valency of the ion. So N will be equal the valency. But here I have a very important note related to N. N should be the valency of the positive ion multiplied by its number or its amount. What is the meaning of that? Suppose we have potassium chloride or sodium carbonate, calcium chloride, aluminium hydroxide. Okay, sodium phosphate. Those ions, those molecules, how can we know the small n of each of them? The valency of positive ion multiplied by its number. So here for potassium chloride, we have one potassium. Its valency from the table equal 1. So the small n equal 1. For sodium carbonate, here we have sodium. The valency of the sodium is 1. This is the positive ion. But here we have two ions of sodium. Therefore, the small n in this case equal 2. The calcium chloride. From the table, the valency of calcium is 2. We have only one calcium, so the small n equal 2. Aluminium hydroxide. The valency of aluminium from the table is 3. We have one aluminium, so the small n equal 3. What about sodium phosphate? Sodium equal 1. But we have 3 sodiums, 3 sodium ions. So the small n equal 3. By the same way, if we have lithium carbonate, the lithium equal 1. And we have 2 lithium ions, So the small n equal 2. Let us apply with some examples. For this example, the first one, what is the concentration in milligram per milliliter of the solution containing 2 milliequivalents of potassium chloride? We should have the molecular weight. Don't worry about the molecular weight because it should be given in any question. Okay? So to solve a question like this, what we have? We have number of milliequivalents, which is 2, of which molecule it is potassium chloride. Okay? And we have the molecular weight, which is 74.5. What is the requirement here? Calculation of the concentration in milligram per milliliter. Okay, so we should know the amount of potassium chloride related to these 2 milliequivalents. How? By applying the formula milliequivalence equal weight in milligram over molecular weight over the small n. What about the small n here? We have potassium chloride, so the small n equal 2. I'm sorry, the small n here equal 1, not 2. Therefore, 2 of the milliequivalence equal the weight over molecular weight, which is 74.5 over the small n, which is 1. This means that the weight in milligram equal 2 multiplied by 74.5. Okay, this is the number of milligrams per milliliter. Okay, here. Number of milligrams per milliliter. Why per milliliter? Because he mentioned that 2 milliequivalents per milliliter. So we don't have a problem in conversion here. The weight that we will have, the result here in milligrams, will be in milliliter. Another example. Here, what is the concentration in grams? The unit here should be calculated by grams per milliliter of solution containing 4 milliequivalents of calcium chloride, and this is the formula of calcium chloride per milliliter. So we need to calculate the concentration in gram per milliliter. We have the milliequivalents equal 4 milliequivalents per milliliter. The molecular weight equal, for the total compound, for the total formula, we should take the total formula, 147. What about the small n here? In this case, we have calcium chloride. So calcium chloride, the small n equal 2. Therefore, the formula, when we apply the formula, milliequivalence equal weight in milligram over molecular weight over the small n. So that the weight, you should put this to remember, the weight in milligram equal 4, the milliequivalence, multiplied by 147 over 2. Don't forget this. What about the answer? The answer will be in milligrams. So let us calculate it. 147 multiplied by 2 equal 294 milligrams. Here he asked about the answer with gram. Therefore, we should divide by 1000 to be 0.294 gram. Next example. A solution contains 10 milligrams per 100 milliliter of potassium ions. Okay, this is the concentration of it. 10 milligrams present in 100 milliliter of the solution. Express this concentration in terms of milliequivalent per liter. So we need firstly to calculate per liter, not per 100 milliliter. Therefore, how many milligrams present in 1 liter? 1 liter or 1000 ml. So how many milligrams of potassium? This will be 1000 multiplied by 10 over 100. So it will be 100 milligrams per liter. Now we need to calculate the number of milliequivalents. How many milliequivalents? By the same formula, milliequivalents equal the weight in milligram over molecular weight over the small n. Don't forget this small n. Even we have the potassium ion, which is small n equal 1. So let us calculate it. Equal the weight that we get, 100 over the atomic weight or molecular weight, which is 39 over 1, equal 2.56 milligram milliequivalents per liter. For this example again, what is the percent weight per volume of concentration of solution containing 100 milliequivalents of ammonium chloride per liter? Okay, here the molecular weight of ammonium chloride is 53.5. So we have the molecular weight. We have the molecular weight. We have number of milliequivalents. 100 milliequivalents per liter. And here we want to calculate the percentage. What is this expression? The percentage concentration weight per volume means number of grams present in 100 milliliter. Okay, so we need to calculate per 100 milliliter. Therefore, the first step in this calculation, we should make the milliequivalence per 100 milliliter, not per liter. How? 100 milliequivalents present in 1000 milliliter. So how many present in 100 milliliter? We should divide by 10. So 10 milliequivalents per 100 milliliter, right? We have the molecular weight. Then the next step is calculating the weight, but the weight here will be by milligram. And after getting the weight, we should convert it into grams. So milliequivalence equal weight over molecular weight over the small n. Ammonium chloride, how many or what is the small n? The valency of the ammonium group equal 1. So small n equal 1 also. So the weight in milligram equal milliequivalence, which is 10, multiplied by the molecular weight, 53.5 over the small n, which is 1. So the weight will be 535 milligrams, which is 0.535 grams. Therefore, the concentration in this case will be 0.535 0.35%. Finally, I would like to thank you so much. For more courses related to these topics, please visit our website www.newptech.com.